Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. Do you know what? Let's just jump right into it. So as you can see, I've decided on a name for this area. This will be the town of Carson. And back here in the background that we're looking at will be Mohave Oil Company. In fact, if we know a graphic artist, I'm pretty sure there are some graphics artists in our group here. I can send you guys some files, or whoever wants to be, and can you convert a file into a graphic picture? It's a tin sign for Mohave Oil Company, but I'd like to get a graphic so I can actually print it on my tanks in the back. So there we go. Decided on Carson. The company back here will be Mohave Oil Company. We're set to go. And since people are probably looking at it, I'm looking down here like, you know what I'm doing. I've actually got track plan. Ta-da! Which is technically upside down, I guess, for you guys. It should be probably like that, right? I don't know. But that is Carson. If you'll notice, I'll actually post a picture. If you'll notice on the picture, you'll see the little checkered boxes all over the place. Those are guidelines for me. Doesn't mean that I'm exactly following this to the exact letter, but it gives me a pretty good idea. And each one of those little guidelines is set at 1-inch square. So it makes it easy to figure out where the track goes. I just have to pre-mark all this stuff, and then I'll be ready to go. So I'm going to take some initial measurements. I can see that we need from the front of the fascia to the back side of the track, we'll need 2 inches. So I'm going to mark that 2 inches. The track width is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5/8 of an inch tie to tie. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I need to go in 1 inch. 2 inches minus. So what I've done is I looked at my plan and I can see at the 2-inch mark, it actually shows up on the outside of the tie here. So from here, the edge to here is 2 inches. What I've determined is it's 3/8 of an inch in. So I've taken 2 inches, subtract 3/8, which gives me 2 inches or 1 inch and 5/8. I've set this up for 1 inch and 5/8, and I'm gonna put my initial lines right down here on the benchwork at 1 inch 5/8, and then I'll run a straight edge to fully mark this. But this should be our initial center line right here. And just to verify, I'll check in and make sure we're 2 inches in from the edge. And we're 2 inches to that tie, which corresponds to what I have on my track plan. So I'm good to go. So I'll run 2 marks here and down here, and I'll take a straight edge and I'll mark that down. At this point, I got my initial line down, so I know where my main's going to run, and I have my center line set so I can install my road bed. But this is where the initial track is going to go in place. I've been basically following the track plan for Carson, as you can see. To give you a little bit of lay of the land here, this is Hermosa Junction. And remember, this is a two-dimensional piece of paper. Granted, this is a two-dimensional piece of benchwork, but things aren't always as they seem. In fact, if you'll notice, there's a little notch right here. When I cut this section of benchwork, I must have realized that I had an extra inch and didn't trim that off. So when I actually cut this section, I did it at 12 inches like I thought everything else was. This is actually 13 inches wider. So I have to fill in this little gap right here. So I gained a little bit of bench work here. But either way, I've been shuffling stuff around. So as we travel down from Hermosa Junction into Carson, we have Mohave Oil Company. And then we come back here to Salt River Sand and Gravel. And that might not even become a sand and gravel company. I'm kind of thinking I like the longer gondolas on it. It might become a scrap dealer of some sort. But we'll see whether I want to keep it with the sand and gravel company, because I think it'd look kind of silly with sand and gravel, and there's really not much there. So we'll figure it out. Maybe a landscaping company, I don't know. But I think a scrap dealer or junkyard would be better there. So on these tracks here, you can see these are our fuel farms. These are our unloading, loading tracks. Basically unloading, because we're bringing in fuel and oils and everything. We're not gonna send stuff out. It's not like Texas or anything. This is Arizona. We have our passing track, our main, and this track here is kind of a storage track where you can use it for a runaround and put extra cars. But either way, that's pretty much where we're at. Like I said, this is Hermosa Junction. Hermosa's off that direction, Carson's off this way. And if you travel under the camera, hit Vermont, Drexel Hill, Gila Springs, works your way back around, and you can't see it over here, to LaGrange. So that's where I'm at. Tomorrow I'm gonna come in and kind of clean stuff up a little bit more, make a couple more decisions. Then I'll start gluing in the, and I got a piece of it right here, the cork road bed. I'm no longer gonna use this foam anymore. Somebody gave me some cork road bed, and it's pretty much what I'm gonna try using at this point and see how well that works. And I figure you guys will come along with me. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and comment down below. Don't forget to find that subscribe button and click subscribe, and that way you'll get every single video I post when it posts. And if you notice, there's a little bell. Bang that bell and you'll get a full notification when I do post a video. And always, I say always, check out that Amazon mystery link down below. I would appreciate that, and you know what? I will see your face tomorrow. How about this? You guys see my face tomorrow.